Every trial, every mountain and sea. Hey, it's your girl The Flame, and you're listening to Pastor Sheldon Evans on 620 AM Favor FM Radio, New York, and Connecticut, New Jersey, Best FM Jamaica, The Journey Show. Keep it.
Listening to Favor FM Radio.
Mighty man of war, Lion of Judah, we worship you today, Abba.
Yahweh, Yahweh, come and do what only you can do.
I'm playing this one for the fathers. Happy pre-Father's Day. All the men that out there, this one is for you. You're mighty man of valor. God is the head of our life. He said he have given us dominion over all things. Man gotta know their position. Man gotta know their place where we stand in the earth. I wanna play this for all the men in Rockers Island. You might be in captivity, but the Bible said, who the Son set free, free indeed. I believe God, for many of you will be able to save. For those of you who believe, just lift your hands and begin to worship and say, mighty man of war, Lion of Judah. I believe chakras to be broken today. In the midnight hour, Peter pray. My God, the angel visited the prison. Chakras were broken. Come on, somebody. I don't know who I'm talking to today. Mighty man of war. Gotta say good morning to those who are on social media. Good morning to you. Please do me a favor, like and share the post. Invite somebody, let them know the Journey Show is on with Pastor Sheldon. And today we got a very, very powerful program lineup for you. Because we have a mighty man of God gonna be with us today. And you're gonna hear his testimony from the street to the pulpit. Good morning, New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. Welcome to the program. My name is Pastor Sheldon Evans, and this morning I'm so elated. And the reason why I'm so elated, first of all, I got to give God thanks. Because he have wakened me up this morning, Sister Marjorie. He have given me another day. The word of God declared this is a day that the Lord have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Anybody glad today? You got up this morning, you're in your right mind. The posture of prayer is on your heart. All faculties are working. Come on, somebody. Oh, Jesus, we give God glory, honor, and praise today. Because he's Yahweh, El Shaddai, King of Kings, Lords of Lord, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. That's who he is. This morning we give God glory, honor, and praise for everything that he's doing in our midst. The Bible said it's not by might, nor is not by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. And so this morning we must realize that when we got up this morning, it wasn't our strength. It was by God's strength. The Bible said, you are our strength, strength like no other. And so this morning, we just give God glory, honor, and praise. Like I said, happy pre-Father's Day to all the fathers that are out there. I want to say good morning, good afternoon to you. Good afternoon, good morning, whenever you're listening to this broadcast, whether it's tomorrow or today. Thank you for being that man that you are and the man of God who's serving God. And if you're not even serving God as a father, I say happy Father's Day. I got to say happy post-Father's Day, pre-Father's Day to my dad, Never Evans. Amen. Glory be to God and all the men that are in my life, uncles and cousins and brothers, all of them. Amen. Glory be to God. But today we want to thank God. Amen. Live on 620 here, New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. Got to say good morning to everybody that's locked into the program. Like I said, those are on social media, please like and share this post right now. Tell somebody that Favor FM Radio is on air. Amen. And just want to remind you quickly, as we about to pray and to give God glory, honor, and praise this morning, but the Journey Show, we only have an hour, so we're gonna get right into it this morning. Like I said, we have a guest today, and that guest is, of course, amen, glory be to God, none other than Prophet Ramando Johnson. Amen. And this man of God is a man of God that, amen, he have been, amen, a blessing to so many. And this man of God is going to be with us here today. He's from the street. Now he's preaching for the kingdom of God. And so we give God thanks for him today. And we know God is going to show up in a mighty way. So we're looking for God to do great and mighty things. So I encourage you to stick and stay with us and don't move the dial right here on 620. For those of you in the Bronx, tell somebody that Pastor Sheldon Evans is on. Amen. For those of you in Brooklyn, tell somebody that Pastor Sheldon Evans is on with, of course, Prophet Ramando, and it's going to be a blessing. Somebody's life will be transformed. Somebody's life will be saved in the mighty name of Jesus. But this morning, I just want to remind you, tomorrow, somebody said tomorrow, you have to join us tomorrow in Brooklyn. We're going to have one service in Brooklyn. It's a special Father's Day fellowship this Sunday at 11:30 a.m. Of course, at EFLM, 10620 Flatlands Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. That's 10620 Flatlands Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. EFLM Brooklyn. My God, it's gonna be a prophetic move. My God, the man of God will be there. Amen. Prophet Ramando Johnson. And of course, it begins at 11:30. And of course, Psalmist. Of course, Pastor Chris Ifield. It's a Father's Day fellowship and barbecue. Start at 11:30, then 4 p.m. We're gonna be having the fellowship with the barbecue. So come on down and join us. Everybody is invited to be there. Amen. To God be the glory. We give God thanks. Amen. So there will be no service in Queens tomorrow. We have one service at Brooklyn coming together for Father's Day fellowship. Sunday at 11:30. Amen. To God be the glory. But we give God thanks this morning. Like I said, this morning we are so elated just to be in the presence of the Almighty God. And this song that I kick off with this morning is very intentional. Because we see in this season, in this time, we have to pray for our men, Sister Marjorie. Because men are very important to the kingdom of God. The Bible said the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence take it by force. And so in this season, I want everybody to be intentional, to pray for the man that is in your life. Because it's very important that you pray for the man. Because we don't understand the enemy. He come to kill. He come to steal and to destroy. But God said he have come to give us life. And so we may have life and have it more abundantly. And so we need to understand what the scripture is saying. That God want us to have life and have it more abundantly. Every man, hear me out. We want to encourage you today. No matter where you find yourself, make sure God is in the midst of everything. Make sure God is the head of your life. Amen, somebody. Make sure God get the glory out of your life, man. Don't let the enemy tell you that you're not wonderful and beautifully made. Because many men go through stuff, you know, that many people don't know. The rejection, hurt, and so much. But all the men that are out there, I want to encourage you this morning. Whatever you're doing, just keep pressing in God. The race is not for the swift, nor the battle for the strong. But you must endure. Somebody say endure, endure. There is an endurance, man. We have to fight. We can't give up in this season, man. Some of you are single fathers that are doing well. Some of you on child support, the wife may put you on child support or that baby mother, and you're going through a very serious time. I want to encourage you. Just be there for your kids. Don't give up. I'm telling you, it's not easy. But I guarantee you that if you take your responsibility in the earth as a man, God will do great and mighty things, man. The word of God declared in the book of Ephesians, he said, God is able to do the exceedingly, the abundantly, above all we could actually think according to the power that worketh in us. And so this morning, what am I saying to every man this morning is about to introduce my guest? I want you to know that God is with you. He said he's never going to leave you nor forsake you. He's going to be with you now, even now till the end of the world. And so this morning, I just want to say thanks to every man that is still standing. Continue to stand. Despite of your situation, despite of what you're going through, continue to stand in Jesus' name. As this morning I'm about to introduce my guest, amen, glory be to God. We thank God this morning for the man of God, amen, glory be to God, hallelujah. As I'm about to introduce him, amen, my God. As I'm playing this song, like I said, it's intentional. Mighty man of war, mighty man of valor. Come on, somebody. I want to tell you this morning, glory be to God. This man of God, he's from Florida, but he's originally a native of Jamaica. And of course, we connected by the Spirit. It's not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit of God. God did it. And so what am I saying this morning? God will get the glory out of his life. God will get everything. And so this morning, I want to introduce the man of God this morning without any further delay. He's our guest. He's going to tell his journey, the things that he have been through and how he have overcome. And so this morning, without any further ado, I want to introduce to everybody this morning, Prophet Ramando Johnson. Good morning, man of God. How are you doing this morning?
Good morning, Pastor Sheldon. Good morning, man of God. I am doing great this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, man of God, for the invitation, for having me on the Journey Show this morning. It's such a pleasure.
Amen. And I just want to... Go ahead, man of God.
Yeah, so I just want to send special greetings to radio listener, Connecticut, New Jersey, New York, on social media platform. We just want to welcome everyone this morning. Thank everyone. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise God. But we give God thanks for you today. Amen. Praise God. To God be all the glory. Hallelujah. Brother Andrew, I'm getting an echo. Amen. Praise God. But to God be the glory this morning. We thank God for you this morning. Amen. Everything that is happening. And so this morning, we want to just get right into the journey this morning. We want to give God thanks this morning for you. And I just want to, amen, get right to it. Because we have limited time here. Amen. But I want you to just introduce yourself to New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. Let them know who Prophet Ramando Johnson is, where you're reigning from. Amen. And so forth. Amen. And of course, give us your child history and where you're from originally and so forth.
All right. Good morning again, viewers. I mean, listener. My name is Prophet Ramando Johnson. I was originally born and grew up in Montreal, Jamaica. Hallelujah. And from there, you know, everything started from there. You know, as a child, you know, I was baptized at a young age, at the age of 12, and was going to church, you know. I know that it was a mighty calling of God that was upon my life and the things that I've been through. And even now, and that when I go back into my past and I just start to think about the things that I've been through, it's only the hands of God. So, you know, as I come on this journey show this morning, you know, just want to talk about my testimony, real testimony. I have so many testimonies. I know we have limited time. I'm not going to be able to say everything, but I just want to give the listener and the viewer a little story of my life, where I'm coming from.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Where the Lord has brought me from.
So what age did you get saved, man of God?
It was at the age of 12 or 13, not quite sure, but it was around that time. I was really young when I first baptized.
So you were grew up in the church?
Yes, I did grow up in the church.
Amen. Praise God. So tell us about your childhood, as in your schooling. Where school did you go to?
I went to Moshet High School. That's in Chelani, Wakesfield, Chelani. Yeah, that's the high school that I went to.
Little Chelani. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I know, because we want to get to the testimonies, because like I said, when we're doing the journey, it will always never be a one part. Amen. And this is part one. And so we want to get the main part of your journey, from where you're coming from, because the journey show is basically about, amen, persons that are coming from, amen, the world, and how, amen, they came out of the world, and how God have transformed their life, and how God began to use them. That's what the journey show is about. From where you are, how you overcome, and how God is using. Because the Bible said the step of a righteous man are ordered by the Lord. So the journey is a show we try to, amen, at least let everybody understand the journey of life, so they will have encouragement to continue with the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And so that's what the journey does. It helps us when other persons give their testimony. The Bible said we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And so I know that it is a part of your life. So you were brought up in church. And did you ever get involved in anything where you were young at a tender age, or you were just in the church?
Well, I was basically in the church. I didn't really exposed to the world until I really started high school. That's when I exposed to the world, and I end up drift away from the church. You know, so that's where everything really began for me in my life. As when I introduced to other, like, children, friends at school, you know, they begin to, like, influence me to bad things.
Wow.
That's where I really get to drift away from
God. Tell us about the drift away. What do you mean drift away? Tell us what that means. When you said drift away, tell us what you're saying there when you said drift away.
Well, basically what I'm trying to say, like, when I get introduced to certain things that I did not used to, I never encounter, like friends and like girls and stuff, because the church that I was really going to, it was very strict. Like, there were like certain religious rules, certain things that I couldn't do. So
yes,
there was like a guideline that I couldn't cross over.
Yes.
You know, so I was pretty much in that guideline where I didn't use to certain things. I wasn't listening to certain music. So it was mostly church. So, you know, I didn't use to things like that. So now I'm exposed to new things. You know, it sounds good. And then, you know, I just began to walk into the bad influence, and then I
yes.
just gifted completely from God.
Wow. 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 Amen. Do you think, and let me stay right there for a minute, do you think that, because of, what happened with you in terms of the strictness in the church and after you go to high school, discover certain things, do you believe that even with youths in church, because this program, I believe, because you are talking to two demographics of people, you're a millennial, by the way. And so as a millennial, you're speaking to the young people. And you're mature in the spirit, so you're speaking to the adult. Do you believe, as you talk about the religious practice that are in church and everything, do you believe that certain things in the church is very strict on the older church than today? What do you think about that?
Well, I believe that the religious mindset can really let young people drift away when they get introduced to new things. And I believe like things need to be implemented, especially to the young people when they are growing up in church. Because you see the thing about it, like if we got, like I had this religious mindset and I thought like certain things, like if I do it, I literally go into hell and stuff. So I was trying to be very careful. So I had that religious mindset. And then, you know, that's where the enemy really comes in and overpowers. So I begin to start to do things that I know I don't use to, things that I never thought about and stuff like that. So those were the things that really get to me. And when I start to like follow my friends, like for instance, like my friends, they introduced me to go to dance. And then when the church found out that I went to dance, it's like everybody wanted to condemn me and stuff like that. So like it just bring a bad taste in my mouth, and I'm saying, well, it's like, you know, like when somebody messed up or fall, we are looking for the church to actually lift you up and to pray you up. But in those times, it wasn't like that. It's like I messed up, everybody started to look at me away, and
yes,
you know, I'm wondering what is going on. It's like, what have I done, you know? So, and then I just, you know, friends begin to talk into it, and you see, that's what I tell you about these church people. And I was pretty young,
yes,
you know, so I said, you know, like, I didn't use to certain things, but the things in the world, they were, like, nice, you know, because I was, like, restricted from doing certain things. So, you know, I really want to stay right here. The restriction in the church. Sometimes, you know, I believe that young people are being restricted from yes. doing certain things. And I believe it's not everything that young people are being are rejected. I mean, restricted from, I believe it can actually like open up their eyes. Because if I knew certain things, if I knew, for instance, like if I cursed bad word or something like that, you know, I could ask God for forgiveness or something. But in those times, if I did, like the church would like come at me and like I did something, like a crime. Put it, I'm gonna use the word, like I commit a crime. Nobody yes. was there to actually counsel me. I said, listen, you got to do the right thing. It was like more like a condemnation where I felt really bad. So now when the church is actually speaking against you, it's just going to drip you more into the world, more to those people, not bringing you, not taking you away from them, but drifting you away. So one of the things that I realized about the church is when persons make mistakes, the church doesn't correct in a sense of to make person feel like you know the word that I want to say, make person feel like they really don't do anything, but at least they did something.
Yes.
But not to let them feel like it's the worst thing ever done. It cannot yes. be fixed.
Listen, I it's well said, and I believe sometimes, let me tell you what the journey, where we want to address is that sometimes, many times I do the journey, and there are some things that God will pick up in certain journey, and we didn't expect to even go here with you, because I didn't even know that, but you're saying something good, because what transformation God have done in your life, it tells me that, amen, that the Bible declare that we should grow up a child the way they are to go, so when they get old, they will not depart from it. And that's what happened with your transformation, because you were brought up in the church from early, and so that transformation that took place with you, it stayed with you, and it continued on and on and on with you, and it never leave you. And so moving forward now, Amen. I know you had a little running with the sports. Tell us about the sports before we got to migrate into the U.S. Tell us about, amen, how you got into sports, because I know you were heavy into soccer. Tell us about that part. Then after that, tell us how, when that, what age did you migrate to the U.S.?
Okay. So when I got to high school, you know, in primary school, I used to play like cricket and football. I was very good. I was a very good athlete on both cricket and football. You know, so when I get to high school, I really focus on football only because it was tough to focus on two sports. So I just had to pick one. So my choice was football because I think I was much better in football. So I actually picked football. So anyway, so when I was in high school, you know, I was a goalkeeper, and from there, when I was a goalkeeper, I used to like play like the Custer Cup those time back in Jamaica.
Yes.
And but this was another thing too. When I was introduced, like even in sports, like it was mostly like, you know, so for me, it was a lot of temptation. there was nothing biblically anymore. There was nothing like, it was just, everything was just a part of the
world. And as a schoolboy football in Jamaica, a lot of girls want to be around.
Yes. So that was a part of it as well, too. A lot of girl everything. So now, you know, everything looked good in the eyes now. And I'm like, you know, start to live the lifestyle as, you know, getting all the attention as a, you know, as a football player in school, you know. Like, you get the attention when, especially when it's game day, everybody comes out and everybody start to cheer you up. And, you know, the hype, it really feel good, man of God. So everything really, like, get to me those time. And I really just walk into it. And I just totally get distracted from everything.
Wow.
So playing sport as well, my God, we were going deeper. Sometimes, like in the church, and I heard a lot of testimony about this, man of God, where persons, like, they're going to, like, it's not easy. I'm not going to say it's easy to play sports and serve God, because the first thing we got to realize that we are up against a lot of sinners. Now, when we are up against a lot of sinners, and, like, it's just you alone, you're not going to church because, and Sunday, every Sunday, I got to go to football match or something.
Wow.
Like that.
Talk so, about it so, right there. Talk about it right there. Talk
so,
about it.
So everything, you know, you're not going to the church anymore. So now,
because matches are always been on Sunday.
Exactly. Match always be on Sunday. So it was like no spiritual strength at that time. Nothing is just, it was just football. So it's not easy. And I didn't really get the chance. So I just like, so you know what? I had to be realized when I fully backslidden, man of God, to be honest with you.
Wow.
It just happened.
It just
so
happened.
Fast. Everything was just
wow.
Like shifted away.
It just happened. It just happened. Just like that.
To that last passion, you know.
You're helping somebody, man of God. You're helping somebody right now. I'm telling you, somebody's being helped right now by you saying this journey. Let's not take this lightly. We're going to get into the prophetic. God is a prophetic man of God. But New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, if you just joined the program, you're listening to none other than Prophet Ramando Johnson. And of course, the man of God is telling his testimony, where he's from. He's originally from Trelawney. He was grew up there. He went to college school, then he went to high school, and he got involved in sports. Amen. Glory be to God. And got involved and start doing the wrong thing. He backslid after start doing sports. My God, you're going to hear more from this man of God. Before we take a break, man of God, tell us the migration from Jamaica to the United States. When did this take place? And tell us what happened before we take the break.
So I migrated in 2004. I came to the state, but I was fully backslidden when I came to the state. When I came to the state, now my mindset was to just come to America and just live the lifestyle. But my God, but it went the wrong way. When I tell you, like everything in my, it's like hell broke loose in my life. I did not have a good time. It was like from 2004, you know, I gotta really cut out some part as we really have limited time. But I just want to give listener a little foundation of where I'm coming from. You know, I know that there was a mighty calling of God on my life because I did not get settled in the word. It's like when I backslided, everything began to go wrong in my life. I had no joy. It's like as I get in one trouble and I get out, I get into another trouble. Nothing was going right. It was like a fence builded around me. Like I couldn't enjoy life. I couldn't settle because I said within myself that I'm gonna come to America and I'm gonna do road. Let me say in the Jamaican church, I'm gonna do road. So my mindset was just the mindset that I had, God had a different plan for me. Because my mindset was to come to America, live the lifestyle, you know, live that lifestyle. Because when we are a child and we are in Jamaica and we're all about America, we just want to get to America. So my mindset was just to come to America, enjoy life, and didn't realize that God had a calling on my life. And he's saying, listen, I want to keep you in the church. I want to protect you. Because a lot of things that was happening in my life, it was God protecting me from let those things not happening to me. So, like, the hands of God was really upon my life, and I really got into some serious trouble. I really got into some terrible things. But when I really look back on my past and look on today, I knew it was God that protected me. I knew it was God that was guiding me, because trust me, like, I have so many testimonies.
Man of God, tell us one of the testimony. Tell us one of the thing that you got into a trouble or anything and how you have overcome right there. Tell us right there. Tell us one of the testimony, because that's what the journey is about. Tell us what you got into.
Well, one of my biggest testimony is, I'm about to share is when I was driving, I had no license, man of God. And my license was suspended. I had no insurance. The car that I was driving, the tag expired. I have drugs in the car, all type of illegal stuff. And I was going to see one of my friends, you know, because I was hustling in the street. So I was taking all type of chances, you know. So I went into a shop where the police was just doing spot check. You don't have to do nothing for them to pull you over. They were just pulling over people. So I ran up into a spot check. Didn't know that there was a spot check in that area at that time. So when I got into the area, I saw a lot of police. So I got real nervous now and I just started to drive. My friend was on the phone with me and I'm telling him, I didn't really know exactly where I was going. So I was taking direction from the phone. From my friend that was on the phone with me. So anyway, so when I got into that situation, I literally began to fret, like get nervous. So I was driving and I didn't even see the red light. The police came behind me, I was driving behind me. I was focused on the police because I knew my situation. You know, real life, I'm talking about reality now. It doesn't matter how tough you are, when you get yourself into certain situations, like that panic is going to come upon you. So I was at that place where I was really panicked, nervous, like them say, listen to me. Them say, if police ever pull you over, you pee up yourself or do up yourself, sorry. But that's how I felt, but it didn't really happen. I feel like I want to pee up myself because I knew my situation. And I knew if the police pulled me over, I knew what the consequence is going to be. So I was really worried. I was fretted, nervous. So anyway, the police end up pulled me over. And when the police pulled me over, like, I told the police that my license is suspended. And the policeman right away took me and put me in the police car with handcuffs. And I had like a rugged ID, not my driver's license, just a regular ID. But it was like a little touring up. It wasn't looking good. So anyway, he put me in the car back with the handcuff, and he took the ID and said, give me a minute. But in the midst, man of God, while I was in the back of that police car, it's like I felt peace came upon me. Like, I just felt something, like I wasn't worrying anymore. Like, I just felt peace. Like, a wind of peace. wasn't even worrying anymore, man of God. I stopped worrying. It's like the Lord just sent his angel. I'm not even going to say the Lord sent his angel. That thing that I felt, the fear that I had, I wasn't afraid anymore. It's like I knew I was going to come out of the police car. Because the way how I felt before
my God.
I went into the police car, that feeling when I was in the police car went away. Everything went away from me.
My
it just
God.
Went completely away. I Jesus. Felt like the heaviness that I went into the police car with the handcuff, I did not have that heaviness anymore. It was like a peace came upon me.
My God.
I felt I was just sitting back waiting. As I knew at that time, something happened. Something happened. So the police went and came back and said, listen, I can't take you to jail, but I'm going to give you a ticket.
My God.
And the police wrote a ticket up and he said, he took the handcuff and said, listen, be careful next time. Listen now, you cannot drive this car. I'm going to give you a chance. I'm supposed to take you to jail, but I'm going to give you a chance.
Come on. Now God listen. Is giving you a chance. My God.
Man of God, listen. When the police took the handcuff off my hands, I knew it was God. Because the thing about it too, I had, as I said, I had illegal stuff in the car. Like I had drugs, I had marijuana.
My
it
God.
It was in the car. So the police didn't even search the car.
My God, come on, look on grace.
Listen,
my God,
the tax
my God
was expired.
Jesus,
I had no insurance.
Come on,
the police didn't ask me for none of those stuff. Man
my
God,
God. Man of
he
God,
just says, I'm going to give you a chance. Be careful.
Gonna give you a chance. Listen, man of God, last night while I was at the conference, Pastor Femi said something, and it just came back to me. We have the favor of grace on our life. There are certain people that God have blessed with measure of grace. All of us have grace in them. But that's grace that God gave you there. Grace, man of God. God Jesus. Give you grace because he have a purpose for your life. New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. Listen, this testimony is mere not finished yet. We're going to come back with the prophet. We're going to take a break because I want to get into how God snatched him out of the world for him to come into the kingdom of God and do the work that he's doing now as a prophet and a man of God. He have many testimonies that the Lord have brought him out with. And tomorrow, like I said, he'll be at EFLM 10620 Flatlands Avenue. Prophet Ramando Johnson will be there. His Father's Day Fellowship. So man of God, just hold the line. We're going to take a short commercial break, pray the bills, and come right back after this. Amen. Don't move, man of God. Keep it locked right here. New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. Keep it locked right here. It's Favor FM Radio. It's your word, praise, and of course, Favor Station. Let's pay the bills and come right back after this.
Favor FM Radio, your number one station for Caribbean American gospel music. Keep it locked.
Count on. Brightside Adult Center is the ideal place for seniors to enjoy fun, festive, and social activities. Our structured activities are educational and entertaining. Choose us to celebrate special occasions, birthdays, anniversaries, and holidays. Our members are provided with nutritious, appetizing meals and snacks. We also provide safe door-to-door transportation. Our social services staff will assist you with any Medicaid or Medicare needs and other potential benefits. Brightside offers learning and engaging activities such as computer instruction and language classes. Did we mention our games and a tournament program? There's more. Yoga, dancing, singing, arts and crafts are just some of the physical activities we offer members to manage their daily needs to stay independent and healthy. Make Brightside Adult Center the place of choice to provide a healthy and joyful living experience to your loved ones. We're located at 2801 Emmons Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. Call us at 718-332-8880. That's 718-332-8880. Or email us at info@brightsidecenter.org. Check out our website at www.brightsidecenter.org. Brightside Adult Center, where care is our priority.
That's what friends are for. Faith FM Radio loves and appreciates you, all listeners. If this ministry has been a blessing to you and impacted your life, here's an opportunity to show your love and support by becoming a monthly covenant partner or sowing a seed today. Log on to our website, www.faithfm.com. That's www.faithfm.com, and hit that donate button or call 866-799-7271. That's 866-799-7271. Please support us as we continue to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ to God's people through music, the word, and testimonies. Thank you for standing with us.
Evangelism, Family Life Ministries, and Favor FM Radio 93.5 in association with Team Kingdom Alliance presents the 12 noon Prayer Power Hour, Monday through Friday at 12 noon, shifting the atmosphere. You must be a part of it. It happens at 12 noon, Monday through Friday. Dial in on the conference call at 646-475-1644. That's 646-475-1644. You can also join in on Facebook Live and favorfmradio.com.
Let Favor FM Radio advertise your business, product, church program, concert, conference today. Call our advertising department and find out about our ideal promotional package to suit your needs. Call us at 866-799-7271. That's 866-799-7271. Number one station for Caribbean American gospel music. Keep it locked.
Welcome back to the program. We have 17 minutes to go. Prophet Ramando Johnson is on his journey today. Those are in New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. I gotta say happy post pre-Father's Day, should say. Tomorrow is Father's Day. I'm playing this for all the fathers who know you are warrior. A Christian warrior. In a me right on. While I was on the break, if you just joined the program, welcome back to Favor FM Radio. The testimony that the man of God gave concerning even the police. The Bible said, "Who that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty God." I believe that God show up in the back of that cruiser for the man of God. Show up with the man of God to be right there. Come on, somebody. Blinded, Lord Jesus. Confused, the police officer. The power of God is very, very serious. God will do some things that no man can imagine. Come on, somebody. We must understand this, that God, when he do certain things, he don't do it like man. I want to welcome back to the program once again, Prophet Ramando Johnson. Amen. A warrior for the kingdom of God, a man of God. And for the next 15 minutes, amen, glory be to God. Welcome back, man of God. Welcome back. Welcome back, man of God. Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. Glory
thank
be
you,
to God.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor.
Man of God, like I said, that right there, God blinded the officer, confused him not to lock you up because God's grace was there. And the power of God that, amen, the Lord have invested in you to be a prophet today speak for itself, because the thing that you have been through and how you overcome. Man of God, for the next 12 minutes, amen, glory be to God. I want to do this because I feel led. As I said, we're going to have part two and part three. You tell us part of that testimony, you backslid, and then, amen, glory be to God. You had the testimony with the police, almost locked you up with drugs in the car, different things. Tell us how you came back to Christ, and tell us how the journey have been, and what God have you been doing now. Amen, glory be to God. Then we're going to speak about the revival, about tomorrow, and then you minister to those that are listening right now, man of God. Tell us the transition. How did you get saved? How did you come back to the kingdom of God?
Well, I recommitted back my journey started back in 2016 when I decided to recommit back my life to Jesus. As I said, I was a backslider. So it really started back in the year 2015, at the ending of that year, where I was going through a lot, like troubles there and trouble now. It's like I was at a point now where I felt like death. Like I felt death was about to take me out. Like I could feel like God was saying, okay, your process is up now. It's time now to come. It's time now to come home. It's like the Lord tricked me. I lost everything like Job. When I said, man of God, I lost everything. I was at a place where I want to commit suicide. Like I wasn't at my same anymore. It's like I felt. But I remember this day. I was at the casino and I sat there. I only had $20. And I just felt this thing like, I just couldn't take life anymore. Like, I don't know if anyone ever been in a situation where you just feel like you just commit suicide, because the thing that come to my mind is like, it doesn't make no sense that I'm here. Even though I am on the earth, but it's like I'm not having any joy, no happiness, nothing, feeling rejected. It's like everything was against the heart. But I get to understand that God allowed those things to happen because he wanted to get my attention, because he sees that the enemy now was getting real busy with my life. So now the Lord used that to get my attention. So I remember this day I sat at the casino and I was just thinking about everything, start to think about my past, where I'm coming from, and everything began to come down. And I began to cry. Tears started coming down. Like nobody understand what I was going through. And the thing about it was at a public place. Like person saw me crying. Nobody came over to me and said, "You okay?" I was just looking and I was like, nobody is with me. So I knew at that time God was trying to like, look, you see, man cannot help you. Only me alone, God, can help you. I was crying. As I said, I had a relationship with God. So I had a church background. So I knew God. So the very fact that I knew God, I said, before I commit suicide, let me try Jesus one more time. I said, let me try Jesus one more time. I just heard this voice say, try me one more time. I wasn't thinking about Jesus. I just heard a voice say, try me one more time.
Come on now.
And I took that voice and I ran with it. And I said, I remember I sat there and I said, God, I am going to give my life to you. God, please, I'm going to give you another try. I can't take this anymore. And I made up my mind. And I said, I am going to serve Jesus Christ.
Come on now. Hey, Katabashata.
I'm going to serve Jesus Christ. I walked out of that casino with $20. And I isolated myself from the... I was really getting there. And I remember I had a cousin. I thank God for her life. She introduced me to this church. And I remember from the first day I went to that church, man of God, I got my deliverance. It's like Jesus. I felt brand new. Oh, I know that I felt brand new because I tried to smoke. I used to smoke, drink and everything. Man of God, I tried to smoke. I couldn't. I tried to drink. I couldn't even curse. I felt brand new. I just felt like something happened. And from that day, it's like I knew something happened. Nobody had to tell me. I knew something happened because I was trying to go back into the world after I got my deliverance. I went to church. Even though I told God and I said, I was trying to go back, but things was getting worse. And I said, okay, now. So in the year 2016 now, as I had left the church and I went back, that was like in March. So we're coming from the ending of 2015 leading up to March. So my friend, I had a friend, he got married that month and was someone in the street. And we decided that we're going to baptize. So I think he baptized that Sunday and I baptized the following Sunday. As I rebaptized again, man of God, from that day, I just begin to walk in my
Jesus.
Calling.
Walk into your calling.
Walk into my calling, man of God. Like I gave up everything. I begin to read my Bible. I begin to do the things. It wasn't easy. I'm coming from a mighty land. It's like it wasn't easy. The fact that I had $20. Didn't know where my resources are coming from. Didn't know where I was going to get money. I knew how to get money. But I said to God, God, I'm not going back to my past.
Wow.
And from that day, I began to walk with God until
my
now.
God.
And Jeez. Never look back. Yes, I have been through difficulty. I have been through temptation. I have been through hardship. But I had a made up mind. So what I'm trying to say, man of God, once we have a made up mind, trust me, Jesus will do the rest.
Come on.
As I had a made up mind. No, because I had a made up mind. When I look back on the things that God has brought me from, it just gives me a passion. And this is where my passion comes from, man of God. This is why I'm so passionate about God, because I knew where God has brought me from.
Yes.
I knew. So every time I think about the goodness of God, it's like I said to myself, I have to live for God. I cannot come to church and play church. As I knew, I have so many more testimonies, but it looks like we're going to have part two.
We have to have part two, but this is what I want to do, man of God. While we're on the radio, because we're going to continue on Facebook and YouTube right here on the platform. But I want to, for the next 5 minutes, to minister to somebody that's listening. I know it's pre-Father's Day. Want to minister to the fathers, minister to everybody, even females also, the woman, minister. Amen. But I want to do this quickly. We're going to open up the phone line. Prophet will pray for you, and we speak a prophetic word also. So I want to open up the phone line in a few. Let me give out the number, but don't call us yet. 718-314-7719. Once again, 718-314-7719. Prophet Ramando Johnson will pray for you. Amen. We're going to be on social media. Sheldon Evans, Our Favor FM on social media. Sheldon Evans, you could come over and watch us, those are listening on the radio. But for the next 5 minutes, man of God, go ahead and minister right now in the name of Jesus. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. We bless God. We tell God thanks. Hallelujah. 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 We bless the name of Jesus. So I'm going to take a couple calls. Hallelujah. And I'm going to minister. Hallelujah. I would love to minister to at least five fathers. The Bible said, young man, I call upon you because you are strong. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't care what situation you are in. I don't care what you are going through. And this morning, we are limited in time, but I want to bless listener all over Connecticut, New Jersey, New York, hallelujah, hallelujah. So I want you to go ahead and call the number 314-7719 in the name of Jesus Christ. There is a person that is listening in the mighty name of Jesus. And what the Lord is saying to me, you are going through a depression. I'm seeing the word depression, but I'm hearing the Lord says to tell you this day, Urabandai, I want to remove depression, because when I look at you, I see where you have been going through a lot of things. It's like what life has brought to you. I see you are feeling discouraged, and I saw at one point you were very active in church, but I hear the Lord say to tell you, I want to remove depression from you. And there is another person on here. You are actually at the place of discouragement, But I heard the Lord said, I want to pick you up. Mighty God, I want to give you a brand new start. There is somebody, you are feeling discouraged. I'm seeing, oh God, the spirit of discouragement. But I hear the Lord said, I want to remove it from you. There is a person on here. I saw you used to be like a prayer warrior, but I heard the Lord said, I'm bringing back that passion. I saw the Lord just put a sword back in your hand, and you even had a vision about the sword. But I heard the Lord said, I'm getting ready to activate the warrior anointing that is in you, says the Spirit of the living God. And even as I'm speaking to persons on this broadcast, God is touching many lives. There are persons that are feeling encouraged right now. I'm seeing the spirit of encouragement. My God, I'm seeing where God's people are being lifted up in the spirit realms. I see God's people are at a low place in their spiritual life. But I'm even hearing the spirit of the Lord said, I want to reactivate your spirit, man, says the spirit of the living God. And even as I'm speaking right now in the spirit realms, there is a person, it's like you have been walking on a path. You have been walking on a path that you knew in yourself, that path is not of God. But something has just touched you as you were listening to my testimony. Somebody, I heard you say, if God can deliver this man of God, I heard you say, today I just want to give God another chance. I want you to just, in the name of Jesus, come on. God is doing something for you right now. Come on. I am seeing a lot of backslider, even as I'm speaking in the realms of the spirit. Yes. I am seeing an influx of people that really wants to give their life to God. But I'm hearing personal saying, church people are hypocrite. But I hear the Lord said, I'm going to remove those thoughts from your mind. And even now, God says, I'm going to touch your mind. Even now,
yes.
God said, I'm going to give you the
in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, God said, I'm going to remove every negative thought, every seed of negativity that was planted in your mind. And there is a person, you are watching me even now. You are listening to me even now in the name of Jesus. And what the Lord is showing to me, I'm seeing church hurt, where you have been hurt in
my
the church.
God.
Not once, not twice, but it's like three times now you have been hurt in the church. And you said to yourself, you're not going back to any church. But I hear the Lord said, I'm going to turn around the situation, what the enemy meant for evil. I heard the Spirit
God
of the Lord
gonna turn
said,
it around for good.
I am going to turn it around for you, says the Spirit of the living God.
My God.
Come on, time is going. Come on, people of God, I want you to receive what God is saying. And I'm hearing the Spirit of the Lord say to tell my people, this is the season of restoration. Come on,
restoration.
I want somebody to be restored, says the Spirit of the living God. And I'm even seeing God is liberating his people. But I'm feeling such a strong wind of encouragement. Many of God's people are encouraged this morning. Many of God's people have been encouraged, because one thing what God is using in this season, especially concerning his servant here, I'm hearing persons are saying in the realms of the spirit, if God has brought this man of God out, why God cannot bring me up? But I'm hearing the Lord said, I want you to believe those words that you are saying in your spirit. God is bringing you out. And I just want somebody to decree and declare in the atmosphere, God is bringing me out. Come on, you have to believe
my
it.
God. Because God is bringing me out.
Urabasha to Rabasanda, because the place that you are at right now, God, the enemy at your place.
Let me give up the number, Prophet. Let me give up the number. 718-314-7719. Call right now. 30 seconds to go right here. Let me close out the program, The Journey Show on the radio. For those that can come over social media right now, Sheldon Evans or, of course, Facebook, please like and share this post or from the street to the pulpit on Amen from Prophet Ramando Johnson page. If you hear his testimony, you want him to stand in agreement with you, call right now. The man of God will pray with you. 718-314-7719. 718-314-7719. God bless you. Next week, same place, same time. Father God, I feel led. Next week, we could do part two in Jesus' name. God bless you in Jesus. Let me close up the program like this before we get back on social media. Glory be to God. We have been through enough. Hold the line, caller. Hold the line, caller. Hold the line. Don't hang up, caller.
I didn't really trust him.
Shake it to the devotion, Dad.
How he longed for me to understand.
Prophet Ramando Johnson, I've been through enough to know God is with him.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing, man?
Not bad. I'm asking for prayer.
God said to tell you this song is for you. And the man of God gonna touch and agree with you, but God said to tell you this song is for you, woman of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
You've been through enough. My God, let me play it a little bit. My God.
I believe that God wants to do something for her.
My God.
Oh, Rabashana. Carla, what's your name, Carla? Rabashata.
My name is Carlene.
Carlene, I want you to put your hand on your belly. Azari beyond that.
Shake
and I
it
hear the Lord said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water, says God. The very thing that you are worrying about, I hear the Lord said, worry not, my daughter, because I'm with you, says the Spirit of the living God. Rabashata. I see like sickness, infirmity, but I heard the Spirit of the Lord said, sickness shall not be your portion, says God. Rabbi, I don't know, but I'm seeing God is showing me healing concerning your life. Do you need God to heal you?
Yes, yes, prophet.
You need healing, right?
Yes, prophet.
It's yours. Do you believe it?
Yes, I believe.
When I count to three, Zaba would be here. If I'm a prophet of God, you're going to feel something happen in your body. I'm going to count to three. Come on, lift up your feet. Get ready for the wind. There's a wind of healing is going to hit you. One, two, three. That's it. Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on,
thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Everything that they have done for you, we find up every witchcraft spirit. We shut it down now in the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
I command your mind to be restored now.
Thank you.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We bless God. My God. Man of God, you can play that song and let you listen to that song.
Jesus, I thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
This one is for you, mommy. This one
thank
is for you.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
We have your number, mommy. We're going to be in touch with you, all right?
You,
God bless you. Hello, good morning.
Good morning, Pastor. Good morning, Prophet.
What's your name or where you calling from?
Rashana Johnson Neal. I'm calling from Cayman.
Cayman. Amen. Glory be to God. Go ahead, Prophet. Are you hearing the woman of God? Johnson.
What's your
Johnson.
Name?
Johnson Neal, Prophet.
Alabashata. Hadabashata. When I look at you, what's the person's name? Rashana Johnson.
Hold on, Prophet. Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute, Prophet. Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute. Woman of God.
Yes, man of God.
Are you a minister in a church in Cayman?
No. No, Pastor.
You have a church here that you go to?
I just come up in Cayman a couple weeks now. I was living in Jamaica.
So do you have a church?
Yeah, I used to go to a church in Jamaica.
No, in Cayman?
No.
I see you connected to a pastor. Sorry, Prophet, God does see this. I see you connected with a pastor in Cayman that you're going to be connected to. Do you find a church as yet?
I'm not hearing you, Pastor.
Did you find a church as yet? Did you find a church as yet?
No, like 5 years ago, I used to go to a church up here. But since I come back up, I haven't go to a church as yet.
Are you still connected to that church? Because I see a pastor that you're connected to. Hear me. There is a pastor that you're connected to, that you're going to be connected with. And Prophet, I see this woman of God going to make a connection with you in Cayman. And this pastor going to bring you to Cayman. Because what God is about to do in your life, it's going to be a testimony. And this pastor that you're going to be connected to is connected to Prophet also. My God. And you're going to go to Cayman. Have you been to Cayman before, Prophet?
No, I've never been there.
If I be a lineman of God, this woman, there's a connection with Cayman, with you and her, to a pastor. Watch what God will do. I don't know if you follow Prophet ministry, but I believe that you know, like there are some things that you gravitate to the man of God. There's something that pull your spirit. Do you know her, Prophet? Do you know her?
Yes, I think I do know Russia.
Excuse me?
And it's broadcast. He spoke into my life more than one time and it's broadcast. And every prophetic word have come to pass.
Makatabo shata. My God. There's about one about to come true, gonna catapult you into your purpose and your destiny in this season, thus said the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And it is not by chance why you're in Cayman. It's not by chance. You're in Cayman. I know probably you're gone for work, but it's an assignment. Prophet, listen to me. This woman of God is connected to a man of God in Cayman that's gonna bring you to Cayman. Watch God.
I receive the man of God.
Because what God is going to do for you, you're not going to be selfish. You want it to spread it to others. And those are in Cayman. You see, God used the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. Because God will allow you to overcome what you're going through the man of God speaking to your life. And he's going to hit you. And so there's a connection that's going to be made for something to happen, a revival, a conference. But man of God, get ready. Watch God.
Jesus, thank you, Holy Spirit.
Direction. Thank you, Jesus. I just want a word of direction. Thank you, Jesus.
Go ahead, prophet.
Hallelujah. My God. God has already used you to spoke into her life. So I seal every prophetic word that was released in the name of Jesus. I pray for you now, Rashana Johnson, and I decree and declare, my God, that your faith don't get weary. I see you getting weary in the spirit. But God says, even as you come on here, God said, I come to strengthen you. And even as the word was released in your spirit, it brought strength to you.
But I'm hearing the Lord.
God even going to open a job door for you, says the spirit of the living God. God said, I'm doing something concerning in your life, because even at times I'm seeing stagnation, but God is going to release some things. But I heard God said to tell you, my daughter, be encouraged. Urabashanda, God is going to direct your path. I decree and declare Proverbs 3:5-6 over your life. And I want you to read Proverbs 3:5-6 for the next 7 days, woman of God, because God is getting ready to lift you up. And I hear the Lord said, worry not, because you see, it's like at times you get at a place where you believe God, you knew God, you know God, but sometimes it's like your faith will waver. But I hear the Lord said to remind you, worry not, because I am with you, says God. And even as the man of God spoke in the word of God over your life, I hear the Lord said, it shall be so in Jesus' name. God bless you, my daughter. And I hear the Lord say to tell you, I love you. And even as I look at the word love, even concerning something with your marriage, I hear the Lord said, I'm bringing back divine. You married, right? I think you do marry, right?
Yes, I'm married. I'm with my husband now in Cayman for the past couple of weeks.
Listen, the Lord said, I am doing something even greater in your marriage. God said, that the conqueror of the Palmer room has eaten
my God
concerning your marriage. God said, I'm getting ready
to
bring
restoration
to your marriage. God said, even now I'm restoring some things. The things that you never encountered, the things that you desire to do with your husband, God is getting ready to bring us, says the Spirit of the living God. And I'm even seeing you will write books, says God. God said, your story will never hurt, says the Spirit of the living God. But the Lord keep on showing me your marriage. And I'm seeing the Lord is doing something in your husband's life. God is about to transform his life, says the Spirit of the living God. And I'm even seeing the hands of God is up on your husband's life, says the Spirit of the living God. I don't know if your husband is saved, but in this season, God is getting ready to touch him. Jesus. When I look at your husband, I saw Matthew. Your husband is a man of God?
He backslide, but everywhere he go, people prophesy and call him pastor. Right. He's the one that lead me to Christ, because when I heard him tell me about church, but he got backslide a couple years ago.
Okay, listen,
my God.
This is what the Lord showed me, because when I just look at this man of God, the Lord literally took me to Matthew. The Lord showed me the book of Matthew,
my God.
And I hear the Lord said he's going to be like a writer of Matthew, because when I look at him, it's like I am seeing him around Jesus, and the presence of God is so strong with him. You see, the thing about it, the enemy knew what he's carrying, so there was something even back in the year 2005, Rabbi Shanna, there was something happened, and I don't know, his father is still alive?
No, his father passed off a couple of years now.
Because I didn't see the father, that's why I asked. But I'm even seeing there was a mourning in his spirit took place in his life concerning his father, says the spirit of the living God. But I even heard the Lord say, Rabba Shatta, that thing that he needed. As I see at times, he literally needs somebody to speak to him. But I hear the Lord say, I'm going to connect him with somebody like a fatherhood. And even for you and your husband, somebody that is going to speak. Where is your father, woman of God?
My father passed off when I was young too.
Okay, because what I'm seeing, I saw both of your father passed away, and that's why I asked. But the Lord said, I'm going to connect both of you, Rabbi Shanda. Think this is even a connection that the man of God spoke about. He's going to be like a shepherd, a father, Rabbi Shanda. Somebody that's going to propel you into your destiny, into your purpose, says the spirit of the living God. And even as you are listening, Rabbi Shanda, something is happening. Listen, I want to count to six, because you see, something is about to happen in your life. Something is about to burst away. I hear the Lord said to tell you, the curse is now broken. The curse that you have been going through, even when you were in Jamaica. I hear the Lord said, the 7-year famine has come to an end, says the spirit of the living God. You're getting ready to walk in prosperity. You're getting ready to walk in something that you desire for. And I'm even hearing the Lord said, I am binding the spirit of poverty off your life. I am seeing where poverty has wrapped you up. But I hear the Lord said, Rabbi Shanda, those broad moments that you had even when you were in Jamaica, God said, I'm getting ready to wipe up. Oh, Rabbi Shanda, I see money in your hand. Oh, Rabbi Shanda. And I hear the Lord say to tell you, my God, there is an expansion that's going to take place in your finances, says God. There's an increase, says the spirit of the living God. God said, I'm going to blow your mind up. One thing I recognize about you, you have the love of God. And I don't know, it's like I saw where God had healed you from some type of sickness. Rabbi Shanda. Has God healed you in some sickness? As I'm seeing testimony, says the spirit of the living God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I am seeing a great testimony. And I'm even hearing the Lord said, I am going to provide like a Facebook platform for you. And I hear the Lord say, don't be afraid, because I'm seeing you with testimony in your mouth. God said to tell you, Ura, the spirit of encouragement is in your mouth, says the spirit of the living God. Woman of God, we're going to continue to pray for you. I am going to take other caller. So God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor. God bless you.
Amen. Glory be to God. 718-314-7719. 718-314-7719. Prophet, I don't know about this song. From you talk about, you know, the things that you have been through. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Have you talked about the thing that you have been through? Amen. To God be the glory, and what God allow you to go through. And the song was dropping my spirit. I've been through enough to know he's going to be enough for me. I've been through some. Let me drop it from top again, Prophet. I feel God on this song. There's something about this song. Let me just drop it one more time. 718-314-7719. Somebody give us a call right now as Prophet continue to pray for the people in Jesus' name. Two more persons.
When I first began to walk with the Lord, I didn't really trust Him. How He longed for me to understand that I could. So through the valley, He led. As I could be.
He have come through so many times, and that put our mind at ease. Hello, good morning. Favor FM Radio.
Yes, praise the Lord, Pastor. I'm praise calling it. For prayer.
Praise the Lord. What's your name and where you're calling from?
Jackie, Queens.
Jackie. Hold the line, Jackie. Hold on. Good morning. Good morning.
How are you, President? Good morning.
Good morning to you, ma'am. How are you?
I'm okay.
What's your name and where you're calling from?
I'm Nicole. I'm calling from Illinois.
Amen. Hold the line, Nicole. Amen. Let me see. I cannot get back to the WhatsApp call. Oh. All right, Nicole. We're going to take your call. The other person is there, but I can't switch back. But go ahead, Nicole. Are you calling for prayer?
Yes, I am.
Amen. Prophet, are you hearing her?
Yes, I'm hearing her.
Go ahead, woman of God. Go ahead, Prophet.
Hallelujah. Sorry. God bless you, Sister Nicole. How are you doing?
Good so far, but I need some spiritual strength.
Need some spiritual strength.
Yes.
And even as you said, thank you. Sorry, excuse me. My God, I know that you are under a spiritual warfare. The very fact that as I wanted to speak prophetically in your life, oh. My God. Oh, God. You see, I'm very sensitive to the prophetic. You know, you are under a spiritual warfare. No, the spiritual warfare that you're under, this is not a really prophecy. This is word of wisdom, word of knowledge, because I flow like this too. So what the Lord is showing me, you are under a warfare. No, the warfare that you are under, it is fighting against your spiritual life. Because the Lord has literally brought you up before me even now. I'm looking at you. What about Shanda Rabahanda? And even as I look at you, I hear the Lord say that you shall be mothers for men. Do you have children?
Yes.
Rabba. Because even when I look at you, I see where your womb is blessed. Oh, God. Help me.
Amen. Hallelujah. Rabahanda,
Rabahanda. How many children you have?
One.
All right, it's okay. Rabashata. I want to pray for your womb. You know why? I gotta pray for your womb. Put your hand on your belly. Father God, I pray and declare, God, that you bless Sister Nicole's womb. My God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. My God, I decree and declare even now, God.
Sister
Nicole, there was something that happened in your life. It was around the age 15. It was in your teenager. Something that happened that you really regret what happened in your life. But God says to tell you, whatever happened in those times when you were a teenager, something that you really regret, something that happened to you unexpectedly, are you with me?
Hallelujah.
Are you with me, Sister Nicole?
I'm hearing you, but I can't recall.
You can't recall?
No.
All right. That's all right. But it was a long time ago. But what the Lord really want to speak to you concerning, it's your spiritual life. The attacks that you are going through, it's to cause spiritual stagnation. You have been at that place for a long time now. How long have you been saved?
I've been saved 13 years now.
Yeah, I know. But you see, you should have been further in your spiritual walk. You should have been further than where you are at right now. You should have been further than where you are at right now. It's like there is a troubling in your spirit. Mm-hmm. Something is troubling your spirit. But I hear the Lord said, whatever is troubling your spirit, in the name of Jesus. You see, God has really shown me some things, but I really can't say over under here. I got to come off the here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pray for you, Nicole. And you can call back us. Your case is a little bit complicated, where it needs to be dealt with in private, because there are stages of things that you need to do. Hallelujah. That God is revealing to me in the spirit. But I can't really say it and here right now. So I'm going to pray for you. I decree and declare even now that God will touch you. I pray right now in the name of Jesus. Everything that you are going through, Nicole, I pray even doors that were shut on you. I pray in the name of Jesus that God will reopen those doors. In the name of Jesus Christ. But I gotta say this. You see, because what I have to say this. As I'm led to say it. You know, Jonah, the Lord told Jonah to go to Nineveh, and Jonah went his way. But I'm hearing the Lord, he said, I want to release you out of the fish belly. Because you see, a lot of things that happened in your life, it was because of this disobedient. Am I right?
I'm not disobedient, so I'm not aware of that one. Yeah. Anywhere the Lord send me, that's where I go. And when I go there, it's always, I always on the attack. People always think that I come to take over, or they're troubled my anointed.
Woman of God, so prophet, can I say something?
Go ahead.
Woman of God, hear me. Let me just pour some wisdom into you. Amen. Because you see, there are certain fights you can pick, but there are certain fight you don't need to pick. Jesus, when he was in the temple, man of God, and he even turned over the tables and say, call it, this was my den of thief, and he left. There are many times the Pharisees and scribes came after Jesus, and he left them. He could have fight them. Even when they came to crucify him, he could have fight them.
Okay.
The songwriter said he could have called 10,000 angels to come at his rescue. You see, many times God will send us an assignment, but we got to know where he's sending us and when he's sending us. There's a timing.
Okay.
The Bible says many that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. And woman of God, let me just say this. Disobedient doesn't mean that you don't do what God tell you to do. It's basically the timing of God.
Okay.
Because God can tell you to do something, but you have to know the timing and the season. Because sometimes we go ahead of God, and we all do that. And we think it's God, and it's not God. So sometimes, you see, when God is leading us to go somewhere, we got to be spiritually mature. Because if God is sending us somewhere, he know the attack that is going to come already. So he prepare us for that. So the disobedience is not just in that you going, but it's you also going and being prepared to go. So when God speak, you got to seek him and say, God, what's the timing?
I need to do?
Woman of God, you said every time you go, I guarantee you, based on the word of God, it cannot be where always you go and the attack came so much after you. Because God will prepare
could,
you.
But they can't try him. They couldn't try him. But I know that I have a warrior anointed.
All right, so you see, you're not listening to good. You're not listening to wisdom then. That's what I'm trying to tell you for you to understand, but you're not hearing me. So I can't explain it to you, because I know what I'm saying. Because I've been on many battlefields, so I know what I'm talking about. Because you're telling me that everywhere God send you, there's a spiritual battle, and you need spiritual strength and the warfare. You see, God not going to just send you everywhere just to have warfare and they coming against you all the time. He won't do that. I'm telling you, there's a time of rest. There's a time when you have your breakthrough and everything. That. But listen to what I'm saying. There's a time when you break through and everything. You got to examine yourself too. See, why is this keep happening? Because there's a root there. You understand the same prophet? You see, God, let me tell you, God is not the author of confusion. Because I've seen this many times happen. And when God sent us an assignment, when Moses was going to go back to Pharaoh, he had opposition. But when he sent him there, he said, listen to what God said to him. He said, who should I tell him, sent me? He tell him, said, tell them, I am that I am that I am. One word he went with. When they come up against you, God got a word for them. The Bible said, no mm-hmm. weapons that is formed against you shall be able to prosper.
Those words. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But you should overcome them. You, if God is sending you to these places, you should be standing. You said mm-hmm. everywhere you I go, stand. They said you want to come to take over because it's the anointing that you have. You didn't hear what you said, you know. I'm saying to you, it can't be everywhere you go, the people are believing the same thing and they come up against you. Okay? If God sent an assignment, because if these assignments need to be completed by the Lord, you must complete it. Got to hear what I'm saying to you. There's something that is missing, woman of God, that you need to see God on. So that's why you have to listen to the word of man of God when him say, you disobedient. Disobedient doesn't mean you won't go, but you got to seek him. God, what are you saying? Because there's sometimes some of us, even include myself, the Bible said, amen, that we have all, and I'm not saying you're sinning, because sin doesn't mean that you have to do something, but the Bible said we have all sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to know, because we can't fight demons, you know, unless you prepare to fight them. And if God have given you that anointing to fight them, you will overcome.
Amen.
Who pray with you? Do you have a praying team?
Yes, I do.
Intercessors?
Yes.
That pray for you specifically?
No, we pray in groupings. Sometimes we pray after for each other.
So you're evangelist or a minister?
Yes, I am.
So who is your covering?
My covering is where I am worshiping right now.
So when you're going out, do they know that when you're going somewhere, they send,
they know. Yeah, because I notify them.
So
don't go out like that.
So you have a ministry outside of the church, and that's
what
you're saying?
I don't go a lot of places anyhow, but you're not going to find everybody's against you, but you always find those persons that, like when you're delivering or so forth, because they don't understand the anointing, they always have this warfare. So I'm being specific. It's not like everywhere. I don't go everywhere. I don't try to.
So you're talking these warfares are in the church?
Yeah, warfare are in the church.
And your pastor know about it?
It's not that. The one that the church that I'm here now is not that spiritual.
That's your problem right there. That's the root of the matter. Did God send you there?
Yes, because I was inquiring and said the direction and everything. I got it, and the name, and I got it.
So if he's not that spiritual, you say you want him to see these things. So what happened? Why you don't see them?
Oh, I can't. There's a lot of stuff I can't talk over on air.
I could tell you what exactly that's going on. You believe God sent you there to fix the church?
Mm-hmm. To clean, do some house cleaning.
I don't see it right now. And we need to understand that the God that we serve, the Bible said the Spirit of God is subjected unto the prophet.
Okay. But he's not the one, you know. He's not the one. There's something struggling.
All right, we're going to pray with you constantly, woman of God. We'll be back in touch with you, but listen to what I'm saying. You got to follow mm-hmm. God's instruction. Amen? You got to follow God's instruction. And remember, if God send you somewhere to do house mm-hmm. cleaning, remember mm-hmm. the pastor there. He's the one that does mm-hmm. that. You can't do it.
No.
So God can't send you somewhere to the house cleaning. The pastor, that's the pastor job. Do you hear that? You can't do house cleaning in a church. That's not biblical. Amen? But God bless you. We got to run. Next caller. Caller running. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Glory be to God. There were some other callers on hold. Prophet, let me say this to you. Are you there, man of God?
Yes, I'm here, man of God. Can you hear me?
Yes. Many times, man of God, you see, there's an order in the kingdom. There's an order that the kingdom have. There's an order that the kingdom have. Order. The kingdom of God have order. The Bible says he gave some. gave some apostles, some prophets, some pastors, some teachers, some evangelists. He gave some, not everybody. And so we got to know our calling when God have called us and what God called us into. Amen?
Exactly. Yes.
And if God didn't call us into certain things, we got to be very careful. Hello, good morning.
Yes, good morning, Prophet. My name is Jackie. I'm calling from Queens, O'Prior.
Good morning, Jackie. Prophet, are you hearing, Jackie?
Yes. Good morning. Good morning, Jackie. You're from Queens.
Yes. Yes, Prophet.
Listen, Jackie, we're going to be, I'm going to be in Queens this summer. We're going to talk about it. But since you are from Queens, I just feel led. You don't want to miss this New York prophetic revival that will be held at the Harvest Room. Hallelujah. July 14th through 16th. I'm going to pray for you, Jackie, but I just want you to know about this prophetic revival if you have not known about it yet. What you want God to do for you, Miss Jackie?
So, two things. I want to get closer to God, much closer, deeper in Christ. And the fear, there's a fear that bothers me, make me fearful all the time. Sometimes he give me a word. I want to give the word, I hold on to it and don't give it because out of fear, what the person, how are they going to respond and stuff like that. So I...
Okay, so this is what is happening, Jackie. You see, it's not, I understand the fear that you are going through, you see. So what I have to pray against the spirit of doubt. Yes. Reason being because, you see, you are hearing the voice, but my God, you see, that's why teaching is very important. In the Bible, the Bible talks about when the Lord appeared to Samuel.
Yes.
Samuel heard a voice, but he did not understand it. And that's why we are here as leaders. You see, Eli was Samuel's leader. Samuel was under Eli. Samuel submitted to Eli, my God. So it was Eli that caused Samuel to know the voice of God. So now what this man of God is going to do, this man of God is going to give you a word of wisdom. So we got to pray against the spirit of doubt because you are hearing the voice of God, but you don't understand it. And even though if you understand it, you are not sure because you are saying you don't want to be wrong.
Yes.
Right?
Amen.
So now listen to me. When I pray for you today, I want you to put your hand on your head.
Yes.
The Lord is going to touch you.
Jesus.
The Lord is going to touch you. You are not just going to hear the voice, but you're going to understand the voice of God. And God is going to give you the strength. God is going to give you the authority to release the voice. Because you see the thing about it, the spiritual realms, you can hear the voice, but wondering if it's the right voice. But God is going to begin to give you revelatory knowledge where God is going to touch you. Even your dream, I see you are a dreamer. My God, most of your dreams that you have dreamt, they come to pass. And that's how God, you see what God is doing right now. God has you on a spiritual training. There is a prophetic calling of God that is upon your life. Listen, what church are you going?
Apostolic, come on.
You see, because you are being restricted, you are being limited. God wants me to break limitation and restriction of your life. Because I'm seeing Rabashata, Rabashada. Even the spirit of humiliation where they want to embarrass you. It's a lot of things.
Amen. Amen.
Am I talking the truth?
Jesus. Amen. Yes.
Because you see, that's where the doubt comes from. Because you see, person, your gift is wrapped up. Person's not going to tell you the truth. And that's why it's like you're speaking the truth, but it's now. I remember there was a time you went to a person and you gave them a word, but the person wasn't receptive to the word. The word was accurately, but the person wasn't receptive to the word. Reason being, because the person wants to let you have doubt in God.
Yes, today, amen, today, amen.
I'm going to pray Jesus. For your confidence. But the Bible said, be confident of this thing, woman
Hallelujah,
of God.
Jesus.
Me who started a good thing in you, God
yes, Lord.
Save you. Glory. I'm going to bring it to completion Hallelujah. Today. I
Thank
decree
you,
and declare over your life
Thank
now.
You,
I speak to your mind. Yes, I God. Speak to you in the prophetic realms. I decree and declare that even now an impartation is taking yes, place in your spirit. I decree yes. and declare everything, everyone that tamper your anointing, everyone Jesus. That belittle you, bind up the spirit of belittlement, everyone that suppress your anointing, I command your spirit now to be lifted up. And I decree and declare that God is releasing Rabashata, Rabasheke, come on, fire in your feet.
Hallelujah.
I command you
Hallelujah.
Now,
Lord,
I
yes,
activate
God.
Everything, come on,
I
come
receive.
On. There is an activation, come on. I just want you to say, Jesus, and feel something happens. Come on, say Jesus.
Rabashata,
come on.
Jesus, Hallelujah.
Come on,
hallelujah. 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 Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Hallelujah to the Most High God. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Jesus. I receive, Lord. I receive. Yes, Lord. I receive. Glory. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
That thing, I stir up that thing inside of you now. I decree and declare now that you have been free. I decree and declare there will be no more limitation. I decree and declare there won't be no more restriction. I command you now to walk in your purpose. I command you now to walk in your destiny. I command your eyes even now to be open in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
That you're walking with me will never be the same.
Glory to God.
We're getting ready to walk into something new.
Yes, God.
I want you to make a couple steps where you are. Oh, I hear the Lord said, I'm pulling you out of that place. My God.
Hey!
I'm pulling you out. Come on. I'm pulling you out. Come on, Zion.
Arise. Glory to God.
Come on.
Thank you,
arise,
Lord.
Zion. Come
Jesus.
On. Jesus. I bind up the spirit of discouragement. Arise.
Yes.
Arise, Zion. Yes, you are called by God. Arise.
Jesus.
And I'm
Hallelujah.
Saying, I am saying Thank the you, spirit of insecurity. Now, what I'm saying is like you don't trust people. You are so skeptical of yes. who is speaking in your life.
Jesus.
But God says to tell you, I'm going to even remove the spirit of insecurity. Ah, Bashanda, from your heart, says God, because when I look at you, it's like you don't, I'm hearing you say, I don't trust nobody anymore, because Jesus. There was something that transpired in your life, but I hear the Lord says to tell you that the enemy is even using that, Rabashanda, and the Lord is saying to remind you, he that started a good thing in you, God says, I'm going to bring it to completion. And declare over your life that this is your season of completion. This
yes,
is
God.
Your year of completion. Everything
Hallelujah.
That was held up, I release
yes.
it over your life.
Hallelujah.
I decree
Thank
and
you,
I declare now, under the
Thank
power
you,
and the authority of the Holy Ghost, I speak to your purpose. I speak
yes,
to
God.
Your destiny. And I decree and declare over your life the purpose can die. I command God now to resuscitate you now. I command God now to revive you now. I decree and declare in your spirit, man, that God is reviving you. He's resuscitating you now. Rabande. Come on.
Thank you,
Give
Jesus.
Nonsense, God. Come on.
Thank you,
I
Jesus.
I want you to stop Jesus three more times. Come on.
Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus. Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank
well,
you, Lord.
Come on. God Jesus. Bless you. And don't forget, you cannot miss this revival. My God. God has
yes.
started something.
Yes, Lord.
So you
yes.
got to come to the revival for God to complete what he has started. Don't forget, yes, woman of God, my God, woman of purpose, come on. I feel birth, I feel purpose is giving birth. Come on, woman of God. I want to push for more time. God wants you. Come on, let go and let God. Come on. Before I release you, come on. I believe that God wants to birth something out of you. God wants to birth that thing. Come on. I am feeling a birthing anointing. Come on. I am feeling an apostle anointing to birth something out of you. Come on.
Jesus.
Come on. Birth. Come on. I stir it up. Come on. I activate that thing. Come on. In the name of Jesus. Push one more time, woman. You are about
hallelujah,
to come
Jesus.
On. Come on. You
are
Spirit, come on, Ramando,
hallelujah.
Come on, man. Don't give up. Don't give up. Something is there. The enemy wants to back it. Come on. Come on, Jesus. You are about to have an encounter with Jesus. You are about to touch the hem of Jesus' garment. Come on, virtue is about to restore. Come on, in the name of Jesus.
God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
My God, even your discernment.
Thank you, Jesus.
God is activating your discernment.
Oh, God. Thank you.
God is increasing your discernment. You are a discerner. You can discern. You are a seer, says God.
Jesus.
But now, and above, Shanda, come on, be encouraged. God bless you, woman of God. God bless you, my God.
Yes, prophet. Thank you, prophet.
In above, Shanda,
hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. My God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God. Let me just play this one. Cause I see like four missed calls, prophet. But I wanted to pray for one more person. Have to get this person on this morning. I know time is up. But remember while you listen to the song, July 14th to 17th, I'm telling you, it's gonna be fire. It's gonna be fire. 14 to 16 at the Harvest Room. And then the 17 at EFLM Queens. The overflow service in the afternoon and in the morning. God is moving.
So through the valley, he led me afraid as I could be till I felt his loving arms. Embracing me, I've been through enough to know he'll be enough for me. He has come through so many times, and that puts my mind at ease for good.
Prophet, you know one thing I like about the journey?
Yes.
Anybody I bring as a guest on this program, they got something for somebody.
My God, my
because
God.
Your testimony hit in so many different ways. To the young people, to people who need to be encouraged, people faith need to go to the next level. Speak to people who have grace or favor on their life. Because everybody have grace, but not everybody have enough grace. It's one grace, one Lord, one baptism, But I believe that there are grace that God have put on certain men to carry out the work.
Yes.
I'm telling you. The grace of measure. Because God have an assignment for special people. And I believe you're one of those persons. That's why grace kept you. When that police, you should have been in prison. But God have kept you. Let me go to one more caller. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Sister Rosie, good morning to you. Good morning. I know you've been been praying. The prophet supposed to pray for you for a while, but not never happened till the time. Today is the day for you to be prayed for. It sounds like you're on speaker today. Can you take off as our speaker, please?
Okay.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Prophet, are you hearing her?
Yes, I'm hearing her.
Amen. So, Lord, that's why I made put it on speaker.
So you can't hear it now, but when it's on speaker, it kind of sound muffled. That's why. We're hearing you loud and clear now. You're not hearing us?
Yeah, but I'm not hearing you loud. You're very low.
So there's something wrong with your phone?
Well, I'm not sure. Maybe I can use, let me put it in my
Amen.
Earpods.
Praise
so maybe
God.
I can hear it clear.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. What's your name? Where you Rosie, I know your name, but where you calling from, Rosie? Where Jamaica you are? Amen. She put in her headphone. Glory to God. The cars are coming in. Hallelujah. Rosie, are you still there? Rosie? Hallelujah. Rosie?
Hello?
Yes. Are you hearing us now?
Yes.
You don't sound good at all, but it's okay. We're going to work with it. Go ahead. What's your request today? What do you want, Prophet, to pray for you? Prophet is on the other line. Prophet?
Yes, I'm here, man of God. Sister Rosie, where are you calling from, Sister Rosie? Jamaica?
Yes, I'm calling from Jamaica.
Okay. Are you a Christian, Sister Rosie? Huh?
Yes, I was.
You was?
Yes.
She said, but.
All right. So you're trying to make your way back.
Right.
All right. Because this is what I'm seeing, Sister Rosie. Like I'm seeing, my God, this is powerful. I am seeing the Lord has put like wings like an eagle on you. Wings like dove. But this is what God is saying. God is saying, I'm making a way for you to escape out of the enemy hand. Because I'm seeing where God wants you to soar away from the enemy. Because I am seeing a lot of traps set up for you. And God wants to put these wings like a dove for you to soar away, soar you out of the hands of the enemy. Because the enemy want to snap you away. You see, from the year started, you have been going through some things. The reason why you have been going through some things, hear the prophet. I am not asking you, I'm telling you. The reason why I don't really normally ask questions. When I do ask questions, I ask questions to confirm. As I know what I'm saying. All right? So listen to the revelation that God is giving to me. So the revelation that God is showing me that I'm seeing trouble. But today, he wants to put wings like a dove for you to escape from the enemy. So there is an emergency calling of God that's upon your life where God is saying, come fully because the enemy is attacking you. There is a tremendous calling. I see where you should have been dead and gone already. God has kept your life. Am I correct?
That's true.
God has kept your life. So listen, I'm going to pray for you. But there is going to be an acceleration power of God that is going to accelerate you. I prophesy over you. If you walk in obedience today, if you hear what God is saying, God is going to turn around everything. I see everything will turn around and come in divine alignment. He's realigning back things in your life, says God. I don't know if you are currently in a relationship yet in your personal life. Are you currently in like a relationship? Okay, I'm not hearing the caller.
Wow. Phone is breaking.
Man of God, I'm not hearing this caller.
Hello?
Are you there, Pastor Sheldon?
Yeah, hello. You're not hearing me, Rosie?
I'm not hearing the caller.
Rosie, you got to call back.
I'm hearing you.
You got to get in a better position. You hearing our prophet?
It's breaking up.
Rosie, you moved a while ago. You moved away. Wherever you are, you move from there, right?
No, I don't move. No, I'm sitting down. I don't move.
You sound different because where you were before, you had was fine, but then we just lose you. Amen. Hang up and call back, all right? Hang up and call back. One more person. Good morning. Good morning.
Hello.
Hi. What's your name and where you calling from?
I'm Natalie Perkins calling from the Cayman Islands.
Hey, man, a different person from Cayman?
Wow. Peter, I don't hear what you said.
Did you call earlier from Cayman or is a different person?
I was calling, but I didn't get through.
Okay. Prophet Cayman is calling you, sir. Good morning, Prophet. Amen.
Good morning. Good morning, Sister Natalie. How are you doing?
I'm good.
What you want God to do for you today?
I know I'm getting a fight on my job, so I need deliverance. I need some prayer.
You need deliverance.
I need prayer for both me and my family, me and my kids.
Okay. So, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, as I bring Natalie before your God, she's requesting prayer, oh my God, for deliverance. I decree and declare in the name of Jesus Christ, my God, I pray for her right now. Listen, I don't really pray for people like this, but what God is saying to ask you, are you a Christian?
No, I'm a turned back Christian. I'm a backslider.
All right, listen. God is calling you back because I'm very, very sharp in the prophetic. And when I pick up, like if I'm praying, I was just praying and the Lord said to stop. Because listen to me, your soul is more precious than gold, says God. God wants you back. To the place that you were. Listen to me. What's your name again?
Natalie Perkins.
Listen to me, Sister Natalie.
Yes,
do
sir.
You used to sing? Did you used to sing?
Repeat, I'm gonna hear both of you one time. Could you please repeat?
I'm saying, did you used to sing?
No, I'm not really a singer. I tried, but
my
kids sing though.
Like you were active in church while you were in church?
Yes, I was active.
What you used to do in church?
I used to be the secretary, assistant secretary.
Okay.
And a part
because
of the church department.
Okay, because I see you were very active in church. That's why I asked. Now listen to me. But what the Lord is showing me right now, God wants to do something in your life. I am seeing a business, Grace. Do you have a business?
I do a small business where I work.
Okay.
But then I'm getting a bigger business.
Listen to the prophet. I see a business, Grace, on your life. But listen to the prophet. It's like I am seeing in the spirit realms. It's like these are like glue that the enemy has glued you with. Listen. Mm-hmm. It's like stagnation. It's like I am seeing a lot of potential in you. But God is saying what is limiting your potential is the attacks of the enemy. Because what the enemy wants to do, the enemy wants to bring you over completely to him so he can have you. But the Lord is fighting. And that's why every time it is like a tug and war in the spirit. Every time you decide that you want to go to church, you feel that intimacy with God, it will just vanish away, go away so quickly. But hear God today. God says to tell you
And I'm seeing you are a person that you have a good heart. You are a kind person. And at times I'm seeing you like you will shed tears. I'm seeing you are a person who will just break down in tears. Like when the pressure comes, you will just cry. Like I see where you like to cry. Like I'm seeing you always crying and shedding tears because of your heart. You have such a great heart. You have such a good heart, my God. You are like a giver, mighty God. But the Lord is saying that I have called you as a warrior in your family. And what the Spirit of the Lord is saying, you are the one that is going to have to deliver your family. So God is saying today that I really want to put an anointing on you to fight for your family. A lot of person in your family is depending on you, says God. But I hear the Lord said to return. And the question is, do you ready to return? Are you ready? Are you ready to return to Jesus?
Yes, I am, because there's nothing out there.
All right, listen. It was not by might why you're here. The Lord ordained this day for you. I'm going to pray for you today. And this is a covenant that you're making with God. Come on. Today, everything in your life is about to turn around. If you walk in obedience, woman of God, woman of purpose, says God. God said, I will do the rest for you. Today, there is going to be a transformation. And even as you are on the journey, so God said to tell you, your journey has restarted from here. Everything that the conqueror, the palmerer, the locust has eaten out in your life, I decree and declare over your life restoration. I decree and declare even now, as you are recommitted back your life to Jesus Christ. I speak to your mind now. I decree and declare that every attack of the enemy, that God will give you the strength. God will send a word of encouragement in the name of Jesus. I pray for you. Amen. I command deliverance now to take place in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. And I command God to touch your mind. Every spirit of confusion, there are times where you feel confused, but in the name of Jesus Christ, I command God to touch your mind now. I command everything that you have lost, my God, I'm even seeing lost memory where the enemy, even at one time in your life, the enemy wants you to go mad, go crazy, but I even bind up the spirit of insanity of your life. I decree and declare now that the mind of God, Rabba Koshanda, my God, will be in you. The Spirit of God will sit in you. I decree and I declare over your life that you are being free in Jesus' name. What I want you to do, I want you to go drink some water after we're done. I'm going to bless the water. I consecrate that water, God, that she will drink. And I declare that everything that was deposited in her spirit, my God, it will flush out by the power and the authority of Jesus. God bless you, my beloved.
Amen. Jesus. Praise God. Bless you, woman of God. Bless you. Amen.
Bless you. Thank you.
Do us a favor. Text us your name to the number, okay? Text your name to the number that you call from. Amen?
Okay. No problem. I'll do that.
All right. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Praise God. Prophet, I know the time is already well spent. Amen.
Yes.
And the time is going. Amen. To God be the glory. I see Rosie trying to call back. Do you want to continue to just finish with her? And that's it. We pray with her because I know the phone got cut off because she wasn't hearing her well. You were speaking over her life and she would be the last caller. You want to do that because she was calling just
right,
now. She's very persistent. Amen. Praise God. Let me just finish with Rosie because we started with her. I want to apologize to everybody that is calling. Amen. You know, Prophet, the Bible said, if he be lifted up from this earth, he will draw all men unto him. And there are so much calls are coming in. And I know that, amen, it's 2 hours we've been on the radio. And sometimes, amen, we know persons need prayer. But we're just asking you to be very mindful of the timing also, because the man of God have an assignment tomorrow. And of course, you want to give him some rest. You want to get into the word. Amen. And so Rosie will be the last caller. Amen. Praise God. Hi, Rosie. Welcome back.
Yes.
Amen. You're sounding
clearly
good now.
Now.
Clear as crystal. Don't move from there. Stay right there.
Okay. Yes.
Amen. Go ahead, Prophet.
Stay right there, Rosie. So, as I was saying, Rosie, I think as you came back, the Lord literally showed me, opened up my eyes again. And as I said before, that I saw like wings of dove have been put on you in the realm. This is something spiritual. So now, Rosie, hear what God is saying. God is saying that it's time for you to run. Now, I said this before and the Lord brought it up back. Are you currently in a relationship?
Well, to be frank with you, I have a baby father, but I've been baptized, and but still, him still come when me day, and to be frank with you, it's just since we, as I would say, him like forced me, harassed me then to have sexual intercourse because I get baptized because of the situation that I was going through. I've got baptized 1 year and I leave him and he's still coming with that. Just
okay, Rose. Okay, the reason why the reason why I asked you and I'm so glad that you were bold to sell it as I really didn't want to say it. Because I see the problem of your foundation. Now listen, if that man doesn't want to marry you, and I'm using wisdom right here, if he doesn't want to marry you, he's going to keep on put you in trouble with God. Because I'm seeing that's the foundation. As I see the passion that you have, you want to do the right thing, but it's like when you messed up, you're carrying guilt. So you see, that's your problem. Yeah. You love God. You have the fear of God. And that's why you are so resistant of moving into the things of God because of your situation. So listen to me now, Rosie. You are in a very complicated situation where I cannot tell you what to do, but I can give you spiritual guidance and tell you what you are up against. The root of your problem is that. Now, that needs to address and need to fix between you and that person. But if you continue, the enemy is going to use that to snatch you away. So God is saying that he put a wing on you for you to soar out of the situation. So God is making a way now. So now you got to be sensitive of what God is doing and what he's saying in this hour concerning your life. Because trust me when I tell you, what about Shaka? I'm even seeing the spirit of abuse. Listen, you are in a very tough situation, but the hands of God is upon your life.
I know.
The hands of God is upon your life. So hear God right now. God is going to deal with you in the next 5 days. Pray about the situation. Pray about the situation. Take it to God. Because right now I got to be very careful what I'm saying. I want you to go to God. I want God to give you his answer that he has for your life. I pray for you now, Sister Rosie. I pray for your mind. And I decree and declare that God will fix what needs to fix. I decree and declare over your life now, Sister Rosie, that the will of God will be done in your life. I pray that you will serve God faithfully. I pray that you will walk in your calling. You desire Jesus. You love Jesus. I pray even now, God, that you will touch her. Mande koto rabashanda. You have so much potential in you. My God. I don't know. Do you can sing or something? Do you can sing?
I can.
You can, right?
Yes, I can sing.
Yes, because I'm hearing a voice in the spirit. I'm hearing you singing, and as you are singing, angels are singing with you. And normally when I see this in the spirit realms, I know that you are something special. Because even when you were a child, even when you were in your mother's womb, the enemy attacked you while your mother was pregnant with you. The enemy didn't want you to come and hurt, but God's hands has been upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Even as I look at you as a child, as a baby, there always an angel came to you, and you are someone that can see things. You are very sensitive. You will know even when evil spirit come around you. You are so sensitive when something is not right. You can tell. That's how I'm seeing you. You are so sensitive. It's that you can see things. You can hear
things. Thank you,
Jesus. Because From you were a child, there was been an age. You are so sensitive. That's why the enemy wants to destroy you, because you're going to be such a mighty weapon for the kingdom of God. The enemy doesn't want you to establish that weapon that God has given to you. But I come to tell you this afternoon as a prophet, mighty God, that God wants to raise you up. God wants you to impact many lives, many young people, says the Spirit of the living God. And even when you were going to school, you see, the enemy tried to rob you from your joy, rob you from your destiny. Because, did you finish school? Sorry.
No, I did not.
You didn't finish school?
No.
Because something happened, right?
I got pregnant when it was about 4 months leave or 6 months leave for me to graduate.
Okay. Listen, what I like about you, you are not afraid to talk. As you see, I saw it. But I gotta use wisdom. That's why I asked if you finished school. But listen to me. That's why I said the enemy tried to rob you. But I know what I saw. So listen, one thing about you, God is gonna set you free. Because of your honesty, because of your boldness, you are not afraid. You are not ashamed. But God says to tell you, mighty God, oh Rabashanda Rabasada. God says, I'm going to touch you. God said, I'm going to make a way for you. Because even as God is giving you the boldness to talk, God said, I'm going to give you the boldness to sing. God said, I'm going to let you use your testimonies to deliver many of my people, says the Spirit of the living God. Walk with God. Be with God. Listen, you want to stay close. Man of God, I want you to take this.
Yes.
Rose, the information.
Yeah, I have her information. You know, Prophet, she's from Tuesday. I think it was Tuesday you called Rosie?
Yes.
When it was on the radio Tuesday night, prophetic zone, and she's been trying since then to communicate. But, you know, this morning I just feel led to call her back, and then she was calling after we was on the live here. Amen. But to God be the glory. We thank God. Amen. But Rosie, we have your number. We're going to be in touch with you. Amen.
Yes.
All right. I have your number, so it's already stored. In Jesus' name. We're going to continue talking to you. Amen? And believe God. Where do you live in Jamaica?
St. Elizabeth.
You're in my parish. Where in St. Elizabeth?
Brighton.
You're
from St. Elizabeth?
That's near to my home. I'm living in Santa Cruz.
Okay, really? It's not Santa Cruz. It's not Brighton in Santa Cruz. It's Brighton in Newmarket.
Oh, that Brighton. Okay, up that way. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I never know there's a Brighton in Newmarket. I have friends up there, the Dyer family and all of them. Neil Dyer. Amen. Praise God. To God be the glory. St. Elizabeth is our parish, man. We're from St. Elizabeth. We used to go to St. Elizabeth Technical High School. Amen. But God bless you. We're going to be in touch with you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless.
Please don't leave me out.
No, we're not leaving you out. We got you. Amen. God bless you. We assure you. My God, prophet, we know all good things got to come to an end. The phone is literally blowing up, but we have to. We can't take no more call. I want to apologize to everybody that's calling right now. I know that you all want the prophet to pray for you, want a prophetic word, but amen. We want to apologize to you. Please don't hold it to our heart. Amen. Hold it to our head, because we have to go. Amen. We have to go. If we continue taking the calls, we're not going to be able to go out here today. And we've been on the radio for 2 hours and the time have been up. And the man of God need to get some rest, going to the word. But we just want to remind them tomorrow, prophet, of the Father's Day fellowship. Amen.
Yes.
Before we go, and we're going to talk about the revival a bit before you go. Tomorrow, meet us at 10620 Flatlands Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. You know, prophet, every year this event is dear to my heart. Because I know I have a mandate for men, amen, that men are to be saved and to serve God. My destiny and purpose, what the Lord showed with men, is to bring back men in their rightful place and position, to let man know that man were made to worship God. And if I'm doing it, they could do it too. And that's what the Lord showed me with for years ago, because every year I do this event because I believe in the men. And there are some hurting men that are out there that some persons don't even talk about. They believe that it's only woman alone hurting, but they're man hurting too. And so this event is geared for the men, but the woman, the whole family, because the family, we invite the whole family to come out. So listen, women, come out with your father, come out with your brother, come out with your cousin, come out with your nephew. Every man in your family, your stepfather, amen, your brother-in-law, bring them out to 10620 Flatlands Avenue. Man of God, I know the Lord have a word for us tomorrow.
Yes, definitely, man of God. There is a word from God, and I just want every one of you that lives in Queens, Brooklyn, Bronx, I just want you guys to come out. You don't want to miss tomorrow's word. God has put a word in my spirit. And this word, listen, man of God, this word was given to me a couple months ago. And I've been working on this word. So you Amen. Know that God wants to speak to his people. So for those of you that lives in the area, I just want you to come out. The prophet is here. You don't want to miss what God is doing. And I want all the ladies to bring a man, either your brother, your nephew, your cousin, bring somebody, invite somebody. Tomorrow is Men's Sunday, and we want to pray for all the men. We want to bring back the men, so invite them. Tomorrow is going to be a special service, and I'm just grateful, and I'm excited. I can't wait for tomorrow. When Amen. It comes to the things of God, I'm just passionate.
Amen.
So today I am here. I'm just going to see God when I come out here and get myself prepared for tomorrow. So Amen. The Lord can use me for his glory.
Amen. 10620 Flatlands Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. It's going to be going on Prophet Ramando Johnson. And of course, after that, 4 p.m., we have a barbecue fellowship, food, music, and a lot of entertainment. Amen. And of course, also, remember, lock it on your calendar. Listen to me, people of God. If you have not locked this on your calendar yet, Prophet, sit up a little bit because you look a little short. Amen. I know you're tall, man. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Listen, people of God, you got to remember about this event. It's going to be happening, of course, the 14th of July to the 16th. New York Prophetic Revival. Listen. Put it on your calendar right now, everybody. I don't know what you're doing right now, but mark it on your calendar. For those of you that may be out of town, you may be out of the country, make sure you tune in to From the Street to the Pulpit Ministry platform, and you will see it live. But not only that, support the vision that the man of God is doing. Amen. Support it. It's going to be a blessing to you. Amen. And I want for those that are in the Queens, Brooklyn, Bronx, Long Island, Staten Island, New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, wherever you are in the tri-state era, you can make your way down. Bring the sick, bring the deaf, come on, bring the dumb, bring the lame, anybody that is sick in their body. People need restoration. Amen. Glory be to God. People that, amen, that feel out of touch with God, you feel like you need another touch from the Lord. And more of all, bring some unsaved persons. Bring your brother that's not saved, your sister, because it's all about souls winning. The Bible said the man that winneth a soul is wise. And so the man of God have a mandate that God have called him. And you know what's so amazing? I'm so delighted to be a part of this vision, because one soul is involved, but the man of God travel all the way from another state, Florida, 1,000+ miles to come here to New York City to have a revival. Come on, somebody. That's like biblical days, amen, coming back alive. The Bible said when Jesus told the disciples to tarry in Jerusalem because he's going to send the Holy Spirit. The point is this, where a lot of churches miss man of God. The reason why Jesus told them to tarry is to wait for the Holy Ghost. That's one factor, right? But not only that, the Holy Ghost was sent. The Bible said that when the Holy Ghost shall come upon them, they shall be witnesses in Jerusalem, in Samaria, and the uttermost part of the earth.
My God.
So when the Holy Ghost came upon them, they had to go out. So that's why the Great Commission, Matthew 20:28-20, it said, go he therefore into what? All nations. So the going forth, man of God, it started right there in Jerusalem.
Yes.
Then they went to different places, Samaria, Judea, yes, and the uttermost part of the world. You see that? So when God, amen, told him to go forth, it's something that we can't take lightly. And so you're going forth by coming to New York City with the gospel. And that's a bold movement of God. And I want to tell you that just continue to listen to God, what God is saying, and just hear the voice of God and let God have his way. Talk to us about it a minute before you leave, Prophet, about the vision.
Oh, God. Well, man of God, this is a vision that the Lord dropped in my spirit earlier this year. And as a matter of fact, from last year, but I was running away from it as I said to myself, I don't ready for this, you know, ministry thing. As I said, God, you are still processing me. And the Lord began to speak to me concerning the revival. And I was like, every time I ignore it, it's like it come right back. And I'm saying, okay, God is trying to get my attention. And then I began, and then I sought the Lord, what team he wants. And the Lord said, bring him back the lost souls to him. And I was like, wow. So the Lord is saying, now the Lord gave me New York, but didn't give me a specific place in New York. As I was looking for now, building Brooklyn, Bronx, Queens, all over. And then the Lord spoke to me and said, I want the revival in Queens. And I'm like, wow. I was getting recommendation other places, but my spirit was like in Queens, like the Lord really had me in Queens. And I said, you know what? I'm going to trust God. And I continue trusting God. And it came when we connected, man of God, and I began to tell you about the vision, and that's where you came in, and God began to speak to you, and the Lord spoke to you and gave you the venue. Because the original venue that we were talking about, you said that you cannot get that one anymore.
Correct.
So now you wasn't thinking about the harvest room. Then the harvest room just came to you.
Yes.
And then you'd call the lady and, you know, make arrangement. And I flew up the following day. I think I flew up the following day. I
Correct.
Bought my ticket like the day before, and I flew up the other day.
Correct.
To see the building. And once I got there, I knew that was the place. And you begin to tour me around the place, man of God showed me. And when I was looking, I was like, okay, this line up with the vision, because that's the place I'm coming from. And I want to get to those souls where I'm coming from, and everything just aligned with my past. When I was walking through, man of God, you have no idea what was going through my mind.
My God.
I was like, look at God, because everywhere you took me, it was like, it reminded me of when I was in the street.
Yes.
And that's where I get this ministry from the street to the pulpit.
Amen.
And we are going to Queens, the harvest room. From the street to the pulpit is going to the harvest room in Queens. You don't want to miss this revival, people of God. It's New York prophetic revival. The harvest room, 90/40, 160th Street, Jamaica Avenue, New York, 11433 of Jamaica Avenue, people of God, from July 14th through to the 16th. Three powerful nights, my God, starting 7 p.m. nightly. People of God, you want to be there before 7 p.m.
That's
you
right.
You want to make sure that you're there on time to get your seat, because that place is going to pack. There are a lot of people reaching out to me already. So people of God, it is a free event. So all you have to do, just come prepare for a word of God.
Amen.
And these are my words, all right?
Amen. Thank you so much, Prophet. We want to thank you so much, Prophet. And Listen, for those of you that did join the journey for money, listen, Prophet just touched the surface because that's how the journey is. We have part one, and I know we're going to have part one and two, three with you, Prophet, because there are certain things we didn't touch as yet, but the main things we touched to a part of the journey, where you're coming from, is very important. And this program is very transparent because there's no condemnation for those that are in Christ Jesus, those that what not after the flesh, but after the Spirit of God. And so the past that people have been through, they have overcome for others. And that's why the man of God carry a restoration ministry, because that's what God have called him to. There is nobody that God ever used have not been through anything. Because the Bible said we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And so the man of God is there to help other people that are coming from the street. The drugs dealer, the Don, all of these different people, because his testimony speaks for itself. So, Prophet, I want to thank you so much, man of God. I want to thank you so much for joining us here today, man of God. I played this song in the beginning, and I have to touch it again, because God tell me this morning, said this song is for you, man of God, mighty man of war, man of Lion of Judah, come and do what nobody can do. And so I want to encourage you, man of God, that as you continue the race and you continue with God, God is going to do some great and mighty things in your life. Amen. So I just want to thank all the people that are listening. Thank God for all the sponsors. Got to say good morning to, of course, our executive producer. Good morning, Sister Corrine. Good morning to you. Good morning, Brother Andre, of course. Amen. Of course, our engineer, amen, and the whole team. Good morning, Pastor Natalie. Good afternoon, rather. Good afternoon, Sister Marjorie. Everybody that's locked into the program, thank you so much for joining us. Remember, tomorrow we have church, one church only. And of course, we're going to be in Brooklyn, 10620 Flatlands Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. But join me tomorrow on the Worship Experience. It's going to be another interesting program. I think we're going to be having Pastor Karen Francis, the preaching police officer for Father's Day. So let me just say this to all the fathers. Before I go, I want to tell you thank you for being the father that you are. And I hope in this season, God will continue to bless you. And God will continue to watch over you and continue to keep you. And so I want to say shalom, shalom, shalom. The Lord bless you. May the Lord's face continue to shine upon you. May the Lord continue to bless you and forevermore. Every man in Jesus' name. God bless you, Prophet. Thank you for joining us today. In Jesus' name.
You're very welcome, man of God. You're welcome.
Amen. To God be the glory. As I leave with this one, station identification.
Fave FM Radio, your number one station for Caribbean American gospel music. Keep it locked.
This one is for your Prophet and all the men that are out there, the strong men of God that keep doing the work of the Lord.
You're listening to Fave FM Radio.
Hi, this is Shirley Willis, formerly of the Grace Thrillers. You are listening to Favor FM Radio.
Mighty man of war. Mighty man of war. Ladies, support the men. Support the men. Give the man them some flowers too. And some cash. Yahweh. Happy Father's Day. I'm elated right now because Father's Day is coming. Come and do what only you can do. Sister Margie, good morning to you. Love you. Yahweh, come and do what only you can do. I'm telling you, mighty man of war, mighty man of valor, come and do what only you can do, Lord.
Come and do what only you can do.
I'm telling this honor to be my favorite song in this season. God is doing something mightily. But God bless you all. We love you. Join us tomorrow. And once again, happy Father's Day to all the fathers. God bless you. Love you all.
We bow down. Yeah.
Favor FM Radio, your number one station for Caribbean American gospel music. Keep it locked.
You're listening to Favor FM Radio on 93.5 FM. You're listening to Favor FM Radio on 93.5 FM WVIP. It's your word, praise, and favor station.
Hi, this is Shirley Willis, formerly of the Grace Thrillers. You are listening to Favor FM Radio on 93.5 FM.